Hi everyone, Kristen here for the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. A baseball weighs about 5.1 ounces, is about 3 inches in diameter, is hurled over 60 feet 6 inches, and has been clocked at speeds over 100 miles per hour. So how do baseball players like Nolan Ryan and Aroldis Chapman throw such a fast pitch? Oh, Roxy. This is my brother Ethan. He'll be helping us today. Professionals make it look easy, but there's actually a lot of muscle groups that have to work together. This includes your deltoids, triceps, latissimus dorsi, trapezius, abdominal muscles, and even muscles of the hips and thighs. Let's watch Ethan throw one more time. We can see that he puts his entire body into it. As much as I enjoy playing catch with my friends and working out my muscles, I'm still interested in the perfect pitch. Today, we're going to conduct an experiment using biomechanics, or the study of how the body works during physical activity. For our experiment, we'll need to record some data. There are three things that we really need to know. Whether our pitch had stride or no stride, we'll need to know the time that the ball spent in the air between the pitcher's hand and the strike zone, the distance between the pitcher and the strike zone. From those two measurements, we can find speed. This is distance divided by time. Ethan plays college baseball and is going to help demonstrate two different types of pitches for us, zero stride and a normal stride. This will help us determine whether the length of our stride affects the speed of the pitch. Like any good athlete, make sure to properly stretch and prep yourself beforehand. First up, zero stride, just moving his arm and not his legs. I bet that felt weird. Let's see how he did. 72 miles per hour, that's still a lot faster than I could throw. Now Ethan will pitch with a normal, comfortable stride. That seemed much faster. Let's do the math. 85 miles per hour, wow, that was much faster. Now we can compare the two. Remember earlier we talked about how multiple muscle groups had to work together to create one fluid movement of the body during a pitch. This means the speed of a fastball is due to the movement of the entire body, not just the arm. Did you get that, Roxy? Oh, and one last thing. Since we're all missing out on baseball season, show us your best fastball using the Amaze Your Brain hashtag. Until next time, bye!